Just a few hours ago, if you're watching this on the very same day that it took place, Rigathi Gachagua requested President William Ruto to leave Raila Odinga to him and his Mount Kenya counterparts. And he's talking about these things of maandamano, disrupting government services, looking for handshake, and things like that. Now, in this video, I want us to analyze why it is that DP Rigathi Gachagua keeps insisting that he be the one to take on Raila Odinga. Because he keeps saying, William Ruto ka kando, ni achiu mzee ya kitendawili. He wants to be the one to take care of Raila Odinga. We want to see why that is the case. And also, I also want to analyze in this particular video why it is that Rigathi Gachagua keeps insisting that he wants to be the one to handle Raila Odinga, but not just he and his Mount Kenya counterparts. There is honestly a reason behind those two moves, and that is what I want us to look into. But before we get into that, if you're here for the first time, please go on and hit the subscribe button. And if you're watching from a different platform, just head on over to YouTube, search for David Wafula, hit the subscribe button, and you're going to be getting a ton of content of this nature. If politics is something you're passionate about, this is definitely the one channel that you really, really need to subscribe to. So in brief, here are the remarks of the DP, then let's get into the topic of the day.
Wewe umeenda umetafuta mzungu pale naitwa Jeffrey Smith, ni mfanyikazi yako. He has a contract with you, he is a consultant. Unatuambia ati yako ati whistleblowing. Didi amesema filimbi ilikuwa kule kwa World Cup. Hii filimbi ni nini unafanya nayo sasa hii? What you are doing, tunakuonea 18 wewe mzee, wewe. Tunakuonea 18. What you are doing is what you have done all the years. 1997, ukashidwa na Moi. Ukaleta Kisirani, ukamutisha nini nini, ukaitwa. You came to government through cooperation. Ukakuja, ukaharibu serikali ya Moi. Aliharibu wako haribu. Katoka hapo, 2007, tukakulima na Mwai Kibaki. Ukaenda nyumbani. Ukaleta shida, ukaitwa. Ukakuja through nusu mkate, ukatatisa serikali. Ukakuja hapo, tukakushinda. 2013, ukajaribu kuleta shida. Uhuru akitaka kuita wewe, huyu alikuwa deputy yake akamwambia hapana, wachana na hii mtu, atatuharibia serikali. 2017, tumekushinda. Umeleta Kisirani, umeuzia Uhuru uoga. Si alimuuzia? Sasa Uhuru akanunua uoga. Akamuita kwa serikali kwa handshake. Aliharibu serikali yetu wako haribu. Tukakwama. Unga ikatoka 90 shillings mpaka 230. Deni ikatoka 2 trillion mpaka 10 trillion. Vijana milioni 6 hawana kazi. Rais wetu nakuomba kwa niaba ya wale tunakusaidia. Hii mambo ya hii mzee tuachie. Dawa ya hii mtu ni mtoto ya maumau. Wewe kaa kando. Kaa kando. Wewe rais please. Endelea na mambo ya uchumi, utusaidie, mambo ya hustlers fund, utusaidie, utafute pesa ya kulipa barabara, uniunge mkono na hawa, utusaidie mambo ya chai, kahawa, mchele, tusaidie. Mambo ya hii mzee, weka kando. Weka kando. Neguo? Eh? Hii mambo ya mzee, tukiwa na hii ya kinandede wa Iguru, wachia sisi.
So the first reason behind the DP insisting that he be the one to take on Raila Odinga is simply because the deputy president has done the math and he knows very well that a sitting head of state, anything and everything they say, becomes national news. There is nothing President William Ruto will say in the course of 24 hours and it fails to feature on NTV, Citizen, KTN, Nation, Standard, and also even on platforms such as these ones. And Rigathi Gachagua knows that very well, and he does not want Raila Odinga to continue enjoying relevance. That is why he's reducing Raila Odinga from taking on the President of the Republic, or rather from the President of the Republic taking on Raila Odinga, and now it has come down to his level. It'll be DP versus opposition leader. Since the last general election, Raila Odinga mainly talks about Chebukati, 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 and if not Chebukati, then falls on to William Ruto, but he hardly ever addresses Rigathi Gachagua, and Rigathi does not want a back and forth between the president and Raila. He wants Raila Odinga's political relevance to dwindle and dwindle, and there's no better way to do it than to take him out of the equation of the president. Now, the second reason is that DP Rigathi Gachagua wants to succeed William Ruto. When William Ruto exits the stage in 2032, Rigathi Gachagua will want to be the man to replace him. So how is that tied down to him wanting to take on Raila Odinga? Here's how. Raila Odinga took on Mzee Moi, Mzee Kibaki, Uhuru Kenyatta. He has literally taken on every sitting head of state and has successfully dislodged them in one way or another. And DP Rigathi knows very well that if he is the man that will finally get Raila Odinga to surrender or resign from politics, that will make him nothing less of a phenom. In fact, if he achieves that and then he goes on to sort the issue of milk, coffee and tea for the farmers, Rigathi Gachagua will be a sure bet to become the next president of the republic if nothing changes in between. Politics is very dynamic. Then Rigathi Gachagua is very smart. You heard him very clearly in that particular video talking about the president should leave Raila Odinga to him and his Mount Kenya people. He's talked of Anne Waiguru, Didi Nyoro and a few others who are present in that particular vicinity. Now why is he talking about these other Mount Kenya leaders? There's a reason behind it, and the reason is DP Rigathi Gachagua wants nothing more than to become the Mount Kenya kingpin or spokesman, if you will. And the elders gave him a very clear caveat. He needs to bring all the leaders together. And so by making it a Mount Kenya versus Raila Odinga issue, that will act as a catalyst to force the Mount Kenya leaders who are still sticking with Raila Odinga to finally change guard and move all the way back to home territory, which is Kenya Kwanza as at now. And that is a smart move by the DP because it's going to put a lot of pressure on Martha Karua, a lot of pressure on people like Jeremiah Kioni and others. And the only way Raila Odinga will be able to hold on to those people is if he gives them good, good money, because he has nothing else to give. He doesn't have jobs. He can't make them CASs, PSs, CSs or anything else, or even an ambassador. That power does not lie with him. But if he has the finances, he'll have to buy them to stay, or he'll be forced by Rigathi Gachagua to watch as his infantry begins to dismember itself into different corners of the country. And lastly, Rigathi Gachagua is a student of history, and so is you and me. We all know that every single time Raila Odinga has gotten his way with government, the one and only thing he's been looking for, other than power, is a secure path in succession politics. This time around, I know that Raila Odinga will not vie in 2027. At least age suggests that, but you never know. He might just surprise us. But if he is not running, he will definitely be there to try and see how he can help his preferred candidate, who will definitely not be found within government. And Rigathi Gachagua knows Raila Odinga's plans, as you've heard him say in that clip, and he will not allow him to come into government to disrupt his prospects of succeeding President William Ruto. Raila Odinga is very good at infiltration. I personally believe if politics was not his calling, then military was definitely his other calling, because as a general, he would definitely know how to get in behind the enemy lines and to take them out. History has seen him infiltrate Moi's government, Kibaki's government, Uhuru's government, and even Ruto's government he can infiltrate. Till now, I don't understand, in my opinion, how it is we are discussing the office of opposition leader. That to me is just another form of infiltration of the government of the day. And when you see Rigathi telling President William Ruto to leave Raila Odinga to them, he's not just telling him, leave the issues of Maandamano to us. Even this issue of opposition leader, leave it with us, let us deliberate, let us get back to you. That statement was covering a very broad context of Raila Odinga. Not just his Maandamano, but also the office of opposition leader. And if Rigathi Gachagua can get rid of both the office of opposition leader and the Maandamano, then he will have protected himself moving into the future in regards to his own succession politics in the next 5-10 years. But as usual, that's just my opinion, guys. Do drop me your own comments in the comment section below. I'll do my best to read them and to give you a response. Now, in the event you're here for the first time, please go on and hit the subscribe button. And if you're watching from a different platform, just head on over to YouTube, search for David Wafula, hit the subscribe button, and you're going to be getting a ton of content of this nature. If politics is something you're passionate about, this is definitely the one channel that you really, really need to subscribe to. All right, guys. Adios.